Hello students, how are you? I hope so all are fine. Okay. Today I am going to teach Sanskrit or Shankar since. Okay. This is my first video and today's my topic is chapter number 2, unit number 2. Dakshina Pada means Dakshina means right, Pada means left. Right leg, our right leg. Okay. Now same thing here. Total 7 shlokas are there. 7 shlokas are different activity. It's, this chapter is depend on males or male is not exercise. How to do exercise? Okay. So this all total 7 shlokas are necessary different. So let me start here on shloka number 1. Dakshina padam purush puru. Dakshina padam puru purushkam. Mandam mandam brahmayatam. Golakaram swayam brahma. Okay, I read it again. Dakshina padam purush puru. Dakshina padam puru purushkam. Mandam mandam brahmayatam. Golakaram swayam brahma. Here if you want to do understand proper understand, better understand, okay. So we will go through our word meaning, okay. So here are all the word meanings are here given. First of all, Lakshya Pada means right leg, our right leg, okay. Purush Guru, that means Purush Guru, put forward, that means our leg put forward, okay. Lakshya Pada, our right leg, behind. Puru means do it, Pushta means behind. That means our leg you have to put behind. Okay? And after Mandamanda means slowly. Brahma means move around. Okay? Tam means in. Golakara means round and round. That means round and round. Okay, and swayam means yourself. Brahma means God. Okay, so let me start your explanation. Dakshina Padam Purush Puru, that means we have to put our leg forward. Okay, Dakshina Padam Purush Puru, that means put your leg back. Manda Mandama Brahmayata, after we have to take the round, slowly. Okay, take a round slowly and after what you have to feel like once you have to stop, okay, then what you have to feel like some of the things are even the steel legs are moving around and down. Okay, these feelings you have to clear here, explain here. Okay, so this is our very simple stroke. Let me start the other one is your transition. Put the right leg forward. Put the right leg forward. Clear? Put the leg back. That means the same thing, right leg you have to put the back. Slowly, take running around slowly yourself, round and down. That means slowly we have to take a round. That means after one you have to stop. We still our round is going on. Clear? So this is the first transition, very simple. Put the right leg forward, put the leg back, turn it round and round slowly and move yourself round and round. Clear? So this is the first stroke, is very simple. You have to write first the slow, after you have to write the one minute and after you have to write the translation. Clear? Okay, now let me start the next stroke number 2. Okay, students, so here let me start stroke number 2. Vama Padam Purush Puru Prushtam Mandamanda Pramayatam Golakara Swayam. Okay, I read it again. Vama Padam Purush Puru Prushtam Mandamanda Pramayatam Golakaram Swayam Brahma. Okay, let me start here. What repeating because if you want to do understand properly, okay, so it's required for our verbing. So here the first number is the Vamapada. Vamapada means our left leg. Vamapada means our left leg. Okay, Purushkuru. Purushkuru means a put forward. That means our left leg you have to put the forward. Vamapadam Kuru Purushtam. Vamapadam. That means our left leg Kuru Purushtam. Do it back. Okay, left put forward. Okay, Purushtam means behind. Do it. You means do it Manda Manda. Okay. Here Manda Manda means slowly slowly. That means one meaning I give you go through our strokes, we have to compare whatever one meaning is there. Okay? So you can understand Manda Manda means slowly slowly. Okay? Slowly slowly you have to take a round. Brahma, Brahma means move round, turn and round. Okay? Tam means it. Golakar means round and round. Swai means yourself, Brahma means stop. That means here what you have to say, that means our you have to put our leg, okay? Put our leg forward. Put our leg behind, back. Okay? And after we have to take a round slowly, slowly. That means after we have to take a round slowly, slowly. So some of you have to take down. After you have to stop, okay? Then after Gulakara Swami, that means after what you have to take, that means since we have to take a round, clear? So this is of our stroke, the first last stroke is there, the right leg, now this of our left leg, understand? So it is a very simple stroke here, now same thing here, same translation is here, but we here put a different only for the result. First row only for right leg, and this row only for the left leg. Another things are very simple as it is. Clear? So same thing here, put the leg forward, okay? Same thing we have to compare on this row. Put the leg forward, put the left leg back. Forward and the back, turn it round and round, slowly and move yourself round and round. That means once you have to take round, slowly, slowly, okay? And after once you have to stop, that means it will be your two state or take around going on. Clear? Okay, so this is of our stroke, it's also very important. That means the last stroke also itself, it will come here, complete the strokes. Okay, so I have here one or two words given. Okay, the last one we have given, and after we have given, you have to complete yourself. That means another strokes, another word we have to complete. Okay, now another these things also it will come in our word meaning. Okay, like that, what meaning means, or I will speak also in the Gama, ask that is Vamapadam, what is the meaning of Vamapadam? Okay, so these things also, this answer also, you can write that, our right answer is that, left leg. Okay, or if there is, what is the meaning of Purushkuru? That means also, if the right answer is a forward. Okay, another is that, Purushtam, what is the meaning of Purushtam? Okay, this thing also you can write down, that means the question is behind. Kuru, that means what is the meaning of Kuru? Okay, this also you can note down. Okay, Mandam means what is the meaning of Mandam? Okay, if you know the answer, write down, write down slowly. You can write, okay, Brahmaya, Brahmaya means what is the meaning of Brahmaya? That means also you can write down, move round. What is the meaning of Samayam? So also you can write the yourself. What is the meaning of Goladara? Okay, so you can write the round and round. What is the meaning of Brahm? This thing also you can write the answer is the term. If it will come in a translate the following sutras. Okay, if it will come like that and translate the following shlokas, so also you can write whatever the shlokas translation is here. Okay, so you can write easily. Okay, so here you have to write same thing, you have to write first shlok, after you have to write the word meaning, and after you have to write the translation. Okay, understand? This is of our parents. Simple thing, let's set a number stroke. Okay, now let me start stroke number 3. Okay, students, so here let me start stroke number 3. Okay, Dakshina Hastam Purushtam. Dakshina Hastam Purushtam. Mandam Mandam Brahmaya Tvam. Golakaram Swayam Brahma. Okay, now I read it again. Dakshina Hastam Purushkuru. Dakshina Hastam Purushkuru. Mandam Mandam Brahmaya Tvam. Golakaram Swayam Brahma. Okay, now same thing here. Let me go to our word meaning. Okay, so you can do understand the reader. Okay, Dakshina Hastam means Dakshinahastam is our right hand. Purushkuru, that means put forward. Dakshinahastam, put forward. Okay? Dakshinahastam, Purushkuru. Purushkuru means behind. Okay? Kuru means to. Purushkuru. Purushkuru means behind. We have to put our hand behind. Now, here, Mandam Mandam. Mandam Mandam means slowly, slowly. Okay, same thing in our last stroke. Okay, Brahmaya means Guram, Gulaka means round and round, Swayam means yourself, Brahma means Tom. Okay, so here what we have to say, the explanation is that we have to put our right hand forward, put our right hand back. After, okay, after we have to take around the slowly, slowly, that means right form, okay, right side. We have to take our turn, we have to take our yourself, so round and round. After it will come, once we have to stop, that means still we have to take a round, okay, that means that we have to stop ourselves and our same thing, okay, but still we have to take a round and round. Okay, this feeling it will come going on. That means we have to take around going on. Clear? Okay, so this is of our expression. So let me start. We have to compare our translation with our slow. Okay, so put the right hand forward. Okay, Dakshinahastam Purushkuru. Put the right hand back. Dakshinahastam Purushkuru. Turn it round and slowly move yourself round and round. Okay, turn what is it? Turn round, round, slowly, slowly. After it will come, move yourself round and round. Okay, so this is of our translation. Clear? So you have to like ask complete the following shlokas. Okay. So these things you have to write complete the following shlokas. After it will come like that, same thing, MCQ or it will come, what is the meaning of Dakshinahastam, Purushkuru, what is the meaning of Purushkuru, Guru, what is the meaning of Guru, what is the meaning of Mandam Mandam. Okay, same thing it will come the shlokas. So you can write if you know the answer. Clear? So this is the also it will come in a word meaning. Okay, it will come also in an MCQ. This translate the following shlokas. So this also it will come in a translate the following shlokas. Okay? So if you know the answer, you can write easily. But one more thing I will give easily. The last stroke is there. First number shown is about the right leg, second number is about the left leg. Now, here, right hand, okay, another thing as it is a Clear? Yeah, right hand and yeah, right hand. Another thing you will do as it is. Okay? If you prepare the student to follow the same thing, you have to write here the structure stuff and the center stuff. Another thing you will do same as it is. So, you can prepare properly. Understand? This is a very simple stuff. So, you have to write the first translate aside this first unit show. Okay, after you have to write the word meaning and after you have to write the translation. Okay, so you have to write in the good handwriting. Clear students? Okay, let me start on the next story. Hello students, so here let me start slope number 4. Here Vama Hastam Puru Suru, Vama Hastam Puru Prushtam, Mandam Mandam Brahmaya Tam, Golakaram Swayam Brahm. I read it again. Vama Hastam Puru Suru, Vama Hastam Puru Prushtam. Manda manda brahmaya tvam golakara svayam brahma. Okay, now listen one more thing is here. Last slok number 1, this is about here written like dakshina pada means right leg. Okay, first number slok about the right leg. Second number show is a Vama Pada, that means a left leg. Okay, now slok number 3 about Dakshina Hastam. Okay, Dakshina Hastam means a right hand. Now here Vama Hastam, that means left hand. Hastam means hand, Vama means left. Okay, so this thing's about, this rule is about the left hand. Okay, now last time say also whatever you have to, if you want to better understand, you have to go by our word meaning. So let us see here what is the real word meaning. Now Vama Hastam, look here, Vama Hastam, that means both are same. Okay, so Vama Hastam means, Vama means left, Hastam means hand. So left hand. Okay, Purusuru. Purusuru means put forward. Put forward. That means left hand or put forward. Vama Hastam. Puru means do. Okay, Purusha. Purusha means behind. You have to put your hand and behind. Manda Manda means slowly, slowly. Brahma. Brahma means move round. Okay, Tam. Tam means eat. Golakara. Golakara means round and round. Swayam means yourself. Brahma means tongue. Now, this is of our word meaning. So, let me start. What is the explanation here? Vama Hastam Purushuru. That means put your hand forward. That means switch which hand? Left hand. Put your left hand forward. Clear? This is a very simple thing. Vama Hastam Purushuru. That means put your hand back. Put your hand behind. Clear? This is the same thing. First time what is saying about put your hand forward, put your hand back. This is a simple thing. Now, Manda Manda Namayata. That means you have to turn around, round slowly, slowly. Okay? You have to turn once, twice, thrice, okay? More than that by 6 or 8 times you have to take around. After, what you feel like that? Gula Gara Swayam Brahma, that means you have to, if you will stop, that means you have to feel like that. Still I take a round, that means all the things is going on. Around us, all the things which are going on, same which are taken around. Same thing like we have to feel. Clear? So, this is of our true expression. Now, let me start what is the here translation part. You have to keep it in mind, you have to, whatever translation is here, you have to compare with our slope. Okay? So, here put the left hand forward. Put the left hand forward. Okay? After, put the left hand back. Put the left hand back. After, turn it round and round. Okay, turn it round and round. After, move yourself round and round. Move yourself round and round. Very simple transition here. Clear? So, here put the left hand forward, put the left hand back. Turn it round, 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 round. Slowly move yourself round and round. Okay, now here one more thing you have to write first of all, write it slow, after you have to write the word meaning, and after you have to write the translation. Clear all? So, this slow is also part of complete the following slokas. Okay, so this thing, this slow also you have to memorize. This thing also it will come in a MCQ ways, also it will come in a what meaning ways. So, if anyone asks like what is the meaning of a Paramahamsa, so if you know the answer, you can give answer, okay, that means a left hand. What is the meaning of a Purush Guru? Okay, this thing, what is the meaning of Purush? Sometimes it will also ask a simple question. Okay, what is the meaning of Brahmaya? What is the meaning of Golagaya? What is the meaning of Swayam? What is the meaning of Brahm? This thing also it will come like that. Okay. So here this is also part of translate the slokas. Translate the following slokas in English. So if I ask translate the slokas, so also you have to write the translation. Clear students? So this is of in our view up to 1, 2, 3, 4 slokas. Okay, so remaining our slokas also you have to come in the next video, but all the things you have to write in your notebook properly. Clear? First, second and third. This way you have to write in your notebook. Okay, so remaining slokas you have to say in a, have you seen in a next video. Okay, students?